So nice to see all of you here.
A very warm welcome to all you lovely ladies and you dapper men here with us this afternoon. Thank you so much for joining the gorgeous Sonakshi Sinha and me over this chat on Transformation Talks. Over the last 1 year, I've often heard how my transformation journey has been amazing, and that really led me to question what is a transformation. The dictionary meaning is actually quite simple and literal. It's an apparent change in form, nature, and appearance. But I think the transformation, the physical manifestation of it, is stage two. Stage one of a transformation is more internal. It's more about a lifestyle change, a mindset change, eating habit change. To be honest, it's more holistic. It's literally mind, body, and soul. And on that note, I'm going to flesh the weight out of Sonakshi Sinha's transformation journey. So thank you for being here, Sonakshi.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me here.
Our pleasure.
Spread the good stuff.
Of course. I have to compliment you that you've killed it. Like how? You were an inspiration, but you're a next level inspiration for, I think, all of us here.
Thank you. But I'd just like to say I haven't killed it. My trainer here, Namrata Purohit, has killed me, which is why I'm looking the way I'm looking. But it's all worth it. Baby, I love you, Nams. Thank you.
There you get your testimonial. So Sonakshi, much has been spoken about your weight loss. Much has been spoken about how you transformed yourself. But would you tell us how much weight did you lose pre the bung, and what were you at your plumpest best?
Well, pre the bung was honestly a big chunk. I was at my peak. I was 95 kilos. I was always an overweight child, teenager. But I was very, very active. I used to play sports. I was very confident of who I was and just very confident of myself. So I felt like at that point in time, I never let the weight affect me. And which is why I was happy being the way I was roly-poly for like the longest time until I actually hit an age where I was 18, 19. And I happened to join the gym because that's what everybody was doing at that point of time. So I jumped onto the bandwagon and I started running on the treadmill, and I couldn't run for more than 30 seconds. I was huffing and puffing, and I was like, oh my God, I am 19 years old. I cannot be like this. So that is where the first switch happened, that I have to work on myself. I have to be able to run more than 30 seconds without, you know, spilling my guts out. But yeah, so that's how it started for me. A lot of people used to keep telling me, I used to get body shamed, I used to get bullied for being fat, but I never took it like, it never bogged me down. I would always fight back. I was very like,
I was
a full like gundi even then. So I used to always fight back, and I used to, in rebellion, I used to eat more and be like, this is how I am, take it or leave it. Until I actually realized that it's not good for me. Some people were saying it to make fun of me. Some people were saying it for my betterment, which is like my family and my friends. So I took that in the right spirit. And I think that's when it all started internally. I lost like about 30 kilos before I started shooting for my first film.
Wow. Yeah. And how long did it take you to lose the 30?
Slow and steady. It takes, you know, everybody takes their own sweet time. I could have done it in 3 months. I could have lost 30 kilos, but I know it would have just been so temporary. It would not have stayed off, and I would have probably ended up hurting myself in the process, done it in a very unhealthy way. But it took me 2.5 years.
Which is amazing. I think slow and steady is the best way to do it.
Yeah, the best way to do it, because it then just kind of stays off.
It's a sustainable loss. But I'm sure, like, I did too. I hit a lot of plateaus. I hit that frustration point where you didn't eat for 3 days and you weighed yourself on the scale and your weight was still up. Did you go through that, and what kept you going during that?
No, honestly, the problem with me is that I really, really love food. So,
like most of us.
If there's anything I can give up, it's everything else but my food, which is where I figured, like, now when I recently started getting a lot more into fitness, taking care of myself, I realized that I have to find a balance. There's anything that you do in moderation is great. You know, that's the best thing to do. Everything in moderation. You cannot starve yourself. You cannot cut out things and just not eat them, because there will be a day when you give up and just put your hands up and stuff your face. So do everything in moderation, which is good. Right now, I take a lot more care of what I eat. I try to eat healthy. I follow a diet which suits me and my body, along with a great workout. I've started doing Pilates with Namrata. And that really, really helped me. And honestly, it's trial and error. I think everybody just needs to kind of figure that combination of what works for you, because everybody is different.
Yeah.
We're built differently. You know, we have different likes, dislikes. Right. We have different temperaments. That's we have it. Different fitness levels. You have to find what works for you.
What rocks your boat. Tell me, Sonakshi, did you get? You spoke about, you know, people telling you you need to lose weight, about being body shamed. I know it, you were always a very tough kid even while growing up. But somewhere did it bother you, and how did you deal with that? Like, did you sort of, you know, you said that you ate a lot more in vengeance, but during your process of losing the weight, I'm sure you must have had to go through a process where people still told you you were overweight, where you still got gave
yeah. After
emotions.
I lost the 30 kilos, they were telling me, I'm like, please talk to the hand. Like, I've worked really hard to get where I am. You cannot take that away from me.
So did you still emotionally eat? Because, you know, we eat our emotions, and that's one of the biggest problems we face.
I would think so. In fact, I would still say that I'm an emotional eater. If I'm feeling a certain way, I do turn to food. But that's fine. You know, you have to understand how you are and what you're going to do, and kind of take measures to balance that out. So even if I eat something now, I know I'll work out, do that extra 30 minutes of cardio tomorrow and burn it off. So it's
or
okay.
Sort of do a cleanse to sort of keep it off, or do you believe in doing cleanses?
No,
like
I'm not
cleanses?
Into that sort of things. First of all, if you put me on juices all day, I'll be snapping at people and, like, you know, biting everyone's head off. Like, I need food to keep my mood in check, first of all. It's so important to just be happy more than anything else. You know, I cannot stress enough on that fact. And until you're not happy from within, it's not going to show outside. And, you know, to want a transformation in yourself, I think you need to first train your mind, and then your body will follow.
I agree with you. It starts with the mind. I mean, I noticed that with myself also. I was an emotional eater. I was a stress eater. I'm a lawyer by profession, and anytime I had a bad day at work, it came out. I think I could do with some chola kulcha. I could do with this. And then you just have to start understanding your mind and, you know, work around that. So what is Sonakshi Sinha's daily healthy fitness routine like? Like, you have a morning routine, you have an evening routine.
Well, I wake up and I try and do cardio on an empty stomach, which I feel it works for me. I don't like to work out after having eaten something, or like if I've eaten something, then maybe after 3 hours or something, that's when I feel empty enough to work out again. So I try and do my cardio first thing in the morning. And like I said, I just started doing Pilates, so I do that in the afternoon. This is on a day off when I'm not working, so I can fit it in. And if I've not done my cardio in the morning, then after Pilates, I do my cardio in the evening. So that is my workout regime.
And what's your typical diet like? What do you know? How did you reach a place that you got to know that this doesn't work for you and that works for you better? Because it's trial and error, like you
trial
said.
Trial and error. I think I just stumbled upon it. I started doing the keto diet for a while. That really worked for me. But then I read up on it, and it's not something that you can sustain. It's not something that you can, and you should not do for a long term.
Time.
So depends on my requirements. Like, I'm working, and if I have a shoot or if I need to look a certain way, I'll go on it, but I'll get off it as soon. And you have to find a balance. So I'm generally on a low carb diet.
A low carb diet. Yeah. And high protein, basically.
Yeah.
So that therefore, you know, you can...
And that really, really worked for me. Yeah. This is something that I had not... Just the thought only of, like,
no pasta, pizza,
leaving carbs
before
this, 1 year before, the thought of leaving carbs was also like, no, I can't entertain this thought. So it was just out of the question. But honestly, when I did it, I started feeling better. I started feeling less lethargic. I used to like
more active.
More active.
Because
you're
on a very low carb diet now, and I feel it sort of helps your mind feel better.
Yeah.
You can think better.
Yeah.
You sleep better.
Yeah.
Did you ever have to work on your sleep pattern? Because sleep plays a very important role in weight loss and just generally, you know, how you feel about yourself.
I'm not the best person to answer that question because I have very bad sleeping habits. I sleep very late. When I'm working, I wake up very early. I need my afternoon nap. I sound like a cat. but yeah, I need my afternoon naps. And yeah, but that is something that I want to get in check. I don't know. I just feel like I can't sleep before 12:31 because I feel like I'm missing out on the day. Like, yeah. I don't know what I'm going to accomplish then. But like sleeping is something that I really need to now keep under check.
So I guess it's an ongoing journey.
Yeah, it is an ongoing journey. And
it's fabulous.
I know I will eventually do it when I put my mind to it. But for now, I'm not the right person to answer this.
So Sonakshi Sinha on a travel, fun vacation with her friends, eating like a glutton. Come back and what do you do? What do you do then when you see your weight is slightly on the upward side? What's your SOS go-to diet?
Get back on your routine. When I leave for a vacation, I tell myself that I'm going to have fun. I'm going to eat whatever I want to eat. I'm going to maybe work out, maybe not work out. I will have those days. And I tell myself that it's absolutely fine. Because I know when I get back, I have to get back to my routine. I have to go through the same grill. If I'm on holiday, I just want to enjoy. And that's fine. I think that if you tell yourself that, then I don't think the calories count. It's okay. You can get away with it.
I agree with you. I think it's so much about mental conditioning and, you know, knowing what your routine is. And
plus, you work hard the rest of the time. And you've not worked hard for nothing, you know. To earn one vacation for yourself. Come on. It's really okay. So, honestly, it's all about loving yourself also, right? You have to go easy on yourself. You can't be too harsh on yourself, hard on yourself all the time. So, for me, what I always say is that even when you want to go to the gym, even when you want to see a change in yourself, do it for the right reasons. A lot of people go in with the attitude of, oh, I hate my body. I need to work out. I need to change it. I hate my body. That's why I'm going to join the gym. No. You love your body. You love yourself. You have one body that's going to be with you for the rest of your life. That's why you go to the gym and that's why you take care of yourself.
It's interesting you say that because to get to this place, I'm sure I didn't start at this place and I'm sure even you didn't. But what was... So journey of transformation is more about self-discovery. What were the things that you discovered about yourself that helped you sort of just or fall in love with yourself? Because clearly you're somebody who's very, very happy with themselves, in love with themselves and enjoying their ongoing journey. So really, what did you discover about yourself during this journey?
For me, honestly, growing up also, it was never about looks because this is not what I wanted to do in life. I wanted to
be a fashion designer.
I wanted to be a lot of things. I wanted to be a marine biologist at one point. I wanted to be an astronaut at one point. I wanted to be a tennis player at one point. So I wanted to do a lot of things, which is why looks was never in the forefront for me growing up. I mean, I was a complete tomboy. Like, my whole life revolved around, like, playing sports. So I used to go to school earlier, play football. My uniform used to be dirty. My teachers used to be like, where have you come from? I was like, I was playing downstairs. So it would be crumpled. And also, that's how I was. And I realized very early on that because it was not always about looks for me, I had so much else to be proud of, to be confident about. Like, I was good at sports, I was good at speaking, I was good at my schoolwork. So I had all these things to be confident about, you know, if not my looks. And it's okay, I was okay with how I was. But unfortunately, I know a lot of girls are not like that. They don't have that mind space, and I would like them to have that mind space. A lot of my own friends, you know, are influenced by the visual mediums, what they see on screen.
What was the advice that you'd give somebody, a 16, 17-year-old girl today? Because you are an inspiration. You are...
Just to not compare yourself to others. Like, everybody, like I said, I mean, everybody has their own journey, their own path. That is the one thing that can just kill you, is just comparing yourself and wanting to be like someone else. No, don't want to be like anyone. Just try and be the best version of yourself.
I agree with you. I couldn't agree with you more. Because that's one thing I realized in the last 1 year as well, that if you really want to keep at it, you want to look good, you want to be the better version of yourself, then just the world doesn't matter. It's the way you see yourself. I mean, after losing 25 kilos, 26 kilos, I'm still told, oh, but you could do, you know, your arms could go, or this could go. I'm like, listen, I've worked hard. I'm enjoying myself. You figure yourself out.
It's very important to enjoy the process while you're at it. Like, I've been working out for the longest time, since I, even before I started acting, because, well, I had to. And it's a very, very big part of my life now. But that did not necessarily mean that I enjoyed it. I used to hate going to the gym. So I used to keep switching up my routine. I used to do yoga for a while, then, you know, just switch to cardio. Then I switched to functional training. Then I used to do weight training. So I used to keep switching. I used to swim. So I used to keep switching it up so as to keep myself involved in it. Until I actually stumbled upon Pilates, and that really worked for me, and I really started enjoying it because I started seeing the results. I think results are the biggest motivator, and that is what you should keep in mind when you want to see a change in yourself. Look at yourself and look at where you started and look at where you've come and where you can go.
That's most important. Sonakshi, for you, even though you never really, the way you looked didn't matter as you were growing up, but now a lot of how you look, a lot of how you groom yourself is a part of your life because of the profession you chose for yourself. But that's not the case for most young girls, most women out there. What would you advise them of how should they keep themselves going? How should they sort of, you know, keep themselves motivated on their journey of wellness, on their journey of self-care?
Like I said, results are the biggest motivator. I think any woman, when she sees results showing on herself, will want to improve on that and keep at it. But honestly, I think fitness should be a way of life no matter what profession you are in. Whether you're an actor, whether you're a businessman, whether you're a housewife, whether anything, whatever it is, it should be a very, very important part of anyone's life because you have to do that for yourself. And 24 hours in a day, I refuse to believe that somebody cannot take out at least 30 to 45 minutes for themselves. Just to get any kind of workout, even a walk in.
That's amazing, Sonakshi. You know, your journey has seriously been inspirational. I've seen you over the years, and I'm sure a lot of other women out there see you and get inspired. And thank you so much for sharing such a, you know, beautiful journey with all of us here.
I'm more than happy to. I hope some of you are inspired and will take up what I said a bit more seriously. And honestly, trust me, you'll be so proud of yourself more than anything else.
It does change your life.
Yeah.
It does. It is life-changing. I'd like to throw in any questions, if anybody has any questions for Sonakshi from the audience. Nobody?
That was really heartwarming to hear, plainly because I understand that your kind of lifestyle requires you to be on the go and still like have the ball in your court at all times about fitness. But Sonakshi, there's something that you said that really hit a chord. You said that it's important to be happy and then do everything, right? Like most of us think that once we are successful, once we get that next promotion, once we get that project, then we will be happy. But you're saying it works the other way around. Can you explain that?
I don't know how to explain it, but I just feel that everything is about, it starts from the mind. It starts from anything that you do, anything that you face with positivity will always give you positive results. If you go in with a negative mindset, it's not going to work for you. And it's a tried and tested and applied formula. Not only me, a lot of people say it, a lot of people feel it, a lot of people do it. And I think that's what I applied even to this. You have to be happy in your head first to be able to bring about a change outwards. Yeah.
Fair point. But in today's age of social media, especially for, I think, the youngest, most impressionable audience that sees even your work over there, when you are comparing yourself, it's hard to keep that positive mind frame. How do you tackle that? Do you have a secret mantra? Do you have something you tell yourself? People talk about affirmations. You talk in the mirror. Do you do something weird like that?
No. I don't do all that.
what do you do?
I don't talk to myself in the mirror. But whatever works for you, man. I mean, everybody has their own different ways of dealing with things, different ways of dealing with themselves. If talking into a mirror works for you, please, by all means, go ahead and do it. But it's just like telling yourself again in my head maybe that, you know, I don't need to compare myself to others.
I think, I mean, if you need to go see a therapist, you need to go see a healer.
Of course, yes.
That also helps.
Absolutely helps. And it's a great tool to like, for your betterment, basically. Yeah.
But if we're talking about wellness and your journey is very visual, right? Like we've been seeing you physically. What's been happening for mental health for you? How do you take care of your mind?
By staying positive most of the time. I think I've always been a person who likes to see the bright side of things. Touch wood. You know, that is something that really helps me. And I try to take out, like, anything that even happens if it's bad at work, I try to learn something from it. So I treat it like a journey that you know, will always teach me something. Experience is the best teacher. So even if it's bad, I'll take out that positive thing with being what I learned from it. So just having a good mind space, a positive mind space, having a support system really helps. I have wonderful family and friends around me who support me, who encourage me, who I turn to if I'm ever feeling low about anything. So that is very, very important, yeah.
So having a good support system, a positive outlook, basically good vibes is good.
Good vibes only.
Got it.
That's a good hashtag.
I think what we're hearing a lot today, even from our last discussion, was mind over matter. And I'm amazed that this is being repeated over and over again. This is a big takeaway for me. I'm sure you guys must have also had some aha moments while Sonakshi was speaking. Thank you so much for sharing that. Seriously.
Thank you.
I'd like to call upon stage Prisha Kotwani and Pooja Duggal. Namrata has a question.
Oh, somebody else also has a question. Okay. Oh, one more person. Good. Now you all woke up.
I actually want to share something about Sonakshi. So, you know, when she came into the studio a while, almost a year ago now, all she had in mind was getting fit. And I think it's never been about getting thin or getting, you know, only about the way she looks. It's always been about being healthy, about getting fit and doing it the right way. And I think that's what's helped her come a long way. And even in terms of what you said, she's always had a positive attitude. It's always been about, I'll get better, I can get there. It didn't matter what people said, it didn't matter. Because there's always someone going to point a finger at you, no matter what you do. Whether you get fit, they'll find something else to talk about, but there's always someone saying something. But I think she's just one of the most positive people out there and very hardworking. So no matter, like, have you done your cardio today?
No, ma'am.
Are you going to go home and do it?
Yes, ma'am.
That's what I mean. But she will fit it in and she is very hardworking and she never misses her workout, ever.
Wow.
Like, sometimes you actually have
to... has to send me home.
Yeah.
Like, she has to, like, go home now, please. What are you doing here?
I actually have to do this to her. So sometimes I actually have to go, like, Sonakshi, enough, leave. You know?
Next one coming in.
And sometimes I tell her, rest, like, rest. It's okay. No, but very hardworking. And kudos to you and your journey.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm kind of jealous of this bromance, man. I don't know who's a fan of who. But awesome. We have another question, I believe.
Hi, Sonakshi. First of all, big fan of yours.
Thank you.
I love your work.
Thank you. What's your name?
My name is Adil Haryanawala. So my question is, do you think sports play a very important role in transformation? Can they replace a gym?
Absolutely. I think, like I said, whatever works for you, sports are a great way to keep fit. In fact, if I could, I would only play a sport, honestly. I used to enjoy playing volleyball, throwball, basketball. I used to swim. So these are things that really, really can keep you fit. And honestly, if I ate healthier while growing up, because I played so many sports, I would have been much, much, much fitter. But my eating habits were very bad. So when you combine a sport with good eating habits, I think you're sorted. Yeah.
Because I play a lot of football. And that
I
really
play football
keeps me
also.
Fit.
I play goalkeeper because it involves the least amount of running. And I would cover the entire goal. So that's why I was goalkeeper.
afternoon, everybody. I have a 12-year-old daughter. Can you tell me about your childhood? How are you focused? I mean, you have a growth. You're mature enough as a fitness freak now. But tell me about the age when you first have the connection with sports.
Actually,
the first connection.
Yeah, I started playing sports at a very, very young age, actually. I used to really enjoy it.
Any state, nationals, district?
I went up to, I think, a district level volleyball.
Oh.
Yeah, so I used to really enjoy it. And I started playing in around that same age, 10, 11, 12 years old. And I continued playing till college. So I really enjoyed it, which is why I kept doing it. You have to understand your child and what she likes, what she doesn't like. Like, if I had not liked playing sports and my parents kept forcing me to join a sport and do something, I would have just developed a real dislike for it, aversion towards it.
Right.
So unless your daughter is not naturally inclined to do that, I would not suggest, pushing her too hard. Like, of course, some amount of activity is really, really good. You should start from a young age, whether it is even something as simple as just track team or running, a lighter sport, table tennis, for example. I mean, it's not light in any way, but of course, table tennis is not as hectic as volleyball or basketball.
So, were you pushed to do the sports, or it was
no,
a natural instinct?
It was like a natural instinct for me. I really enjoyed. I'm athletic by nature, so
yeah.
That is why I wanted to play sports.
Glad to know that. I'm into fitness from last 30 years, and my both the daughters, age 7 and 12. I mean, I don't push them. They naturally
but
connect.
That's great. I feel like if they you're so much into fitness and they watch you,
yeah.
I think it'll come to them. Like I'm
yeah,
sure
it comes naturally
to
them.
Yeah,
so that only I'm asking you. Yeah. I mean, you were pushed because a lot
I'm
of kids
sure they'll
because
be inspired
now,
by you.
Now the kids which are growing, they are hooked up to a lot of gadgets, TV, mobiles, and everything. So you need to push them. Go to an open area, go for a track.
You need to encourage them to get out more and play. Outdoor games are definitely a must, I think. We've lost that, in this generation.
Yeah.
So that, I think, needs to be encouraged.
Yeah.
So we have
grown for a maturity level to understand sports, athletic, fitness. But the younger generation is lacking that. So when we push them to in that side, they just get, stressed. They get more frustrated about doing things.
Yeah.
And because the physical thing is not coming out, they're just using their mental brains for that.
Yeah.
For that one.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Gladia. Yeah. Yeah.
Sonakshi, I'm sorry. May I? I feel like this is quite a unique gathering. I mean, as compared to all the other PR events, I'm sure that you go for.
It is. It's so personal. And like, I feel like I'm connecting and talking to each and every one of you sitting here. So that's great.
Yeah, and we're feeling so intimately close to you right now. But the entire agenda of Health Hunt to have this event today is to explain or at least show to all of us that wellness at every single stage is possible.
Yeah.
What do you feel about this initiative?
Absolutely. It's never too late to start. That is something that I will say, whether you're 6 years old or 60 years old or older, you're the only one who can stop yourself from achieving what you want. So I'm just going to say it's never too late to start.
And if we don't talk about wellness in 2018, when will we talk about it? Why do you think it's important today?
It was important, honestly, yesterday and the day before that. I think we should have introduced this conversation a long time ago. Not just promoting physical fitness, mental fitness as well. And I'm really glad what you guys are doing. What you guys are doing is so good, having these wonderful people come up on your panels and talk. And I'm so happy to be here and share and interact with all of you. So I think it's great. I'm glad the conversation has started and I hope that it continues to happen,
Absolutely. I think we're not looking for a happy ending to this, but a new beginning.
Absolutely.
And we're all part of this equally. So thank
See,
you
already
so much
positive
Yeah, look at my
thoughts.
Face.
Yeah.
It's glowing, guys. I think it's infectious. I don't know if you guys are smiling as wide as me, but I can't help it. Maybe...
share the wealth. Absolutely. And thank you so much, really, for being a part of it. I think it inspires. Every day they see your inspiration daily, even through your work. But when it's so personalized and so customized, through a platform, it comes out in such a unique, customized manner. So really, from our hearts, we're happy that you did this for the audiences. Thank you. Thank you. I think जितनी ज़रूरत होती है उतना ही करना पड़ता है. I think हर किसी को जो अलग अलग होते हैं, मुझे खाने से बहुत लगाव है, तो पर मैंने थोड़ा ज़्यादा ध्यान दिया. And of course, sacrifice तो पूरी तरह से कुछ भी नहीं करना चाहिए. जितनी एक लाइफ होती है, आप अच्छे से जियो उसको, खुश रहो, काम करो. और अगर आप पहले से खुश नहीं हो तो काम भी ठीक से नहीं होगा. सो वेरी वेरी हैप्पी एंड हेल्दी. I walked in, I came here, and I'm good. My fitness mantra is, I think consistency is key. Anything that you find, you should find something that you really love to do, and be consistent with it. Last question. Bob, is that okay? Maybe go home, yeah, but shooting jari hai na.